The home assessed in this video was built in 1992. The early 90s saw a growing awareness of energy efficiency, but the standards were not as stringent as today. Houses were not sealed properly, and the average size of a new home in 1992 was about 2,095 square feet. So opportunities to do so are plentiful. Most homes used R11 to R15 insulation in walls, which is fine, and R30 in attics, which is lower than today's standards. During John's energy audit, we climbed up to the attic, often the heart of home efficiency. As I inspected the space, I explained to John that this part of the house usually hides incredible potential for saving energy and improving comfort. "Take this attic hatch," I said, pointing to the small, uninsulated panel. "It's one of the biggest culprits. Warm air leaks out in the winter and cool air in the summer." John looked surprised, not realizing that such a small spot could significantly impact his comfort. I showed him how to seal it using rigid foam board and weather stripping to lock in the air. It was a simple but crucial step in making his home more efficient. As we continued the attic assessment, I showed John the ductwork. "See these little gaps?" I pointed out the spaces where the ducts connected. "That's where your air is escaping." John hadn't thought much about it before, but these small leaks were clearly costing him comfort and money. By sealing those ducts and adding insulation, we'd ensure his home could hold on to the air he was paying to heat and cool. It was a simple fix, but one that made all the difference. John was starting to see the power of these minor adjustments. As we moved deeper into the attic, I pointed out the baffles near the eaves. "John, it looks like your soffits are open, but your existing baffles are a little short," I explained. "If you add insulation, new baffles should be installed to maintain the air pathway." He nodded, realizing how maintaining good ventilation in the attic is important. By installing the baffles correctly, we'd ensure his attic would stay insulated while maintaining proper ventilation, a simple solution for long-term efficiency. John was beginning to see how even the unseen parts of his attic played a vital role in keeping his home comfortable. During the attic assessment, I pointed to John's bathroom fan. "You wouldn't think this could cause a problem," I said, "but take a look at this thermal image." The screen showed a glaring hot spot, over 100 degrees, right where the fan was installed. John was surprised. "I had no idea that could happen," he said. I explained how even small gaps around installations like the bathroom fan can lead to energy loss, making rooms harder to cool. As we moved through the attic, I showed John a common culprit, plumbing penetrations. "See how this pipe goes through the attic floor?" I asked. "It's like a round peg in a square hole, leaving gaps for air to escape." John looked closer, surprised at how much space was left around the pipe. "We'll seal these gaps with foam," I explained. "It's a quick fix, but it makes a huge difference in keeping your air where it belongs." John could see now how even the smallest gaps could have a big impact on his home's comfort and efficiency. As we inspected John's attic, we came across the knee wall, a seemingly small part of the house that can cause significant issues if left untreated. "John, this wall here," I explained, "separates your attic from your living space, and right now it's leaking conditioned air, wasting energy." Knee walls, especially in homes with sloped ceilings, are notorious for air leaks. Poor insulation or ceiling can lead to significant heat loss in the winter and heat gain in the summer. I told John an interesting fact. Homes with poorly insulated knee walls often experience noticeable comfort problems because of how heat escapes through these gaps. I then pointed out how sealing the cracks and insulating the wall properly would prevent this thermal loss. "By doing this, John, you can save energy and reduce utility bills. It's a small area, but it plays a big role in keeping your home comfortable." As we continued through the attic, we visited an area John had been curious about, a large, oddly shaped dead space. "This pocket here," I explained, "is a big part of why you're feeling uneven temperatures in the house." John had already suspected something was off. He used a thermal camera from the local library, but now he could see how this area connected the attic to the inside of his house. I showed him how to block it off and adequately insulate it so it makes a real difference. John saw that his attic needed a little love in several places so it could start working for him instead of against him. John was surprised at how different his attic would look. The holes would be sealed, the insulation would be appropriately installed, and the ventilation systems would be correctly aligned. An attic like this helps your home feel more comfortable and balanced, I said. By the end of the audit, John understood the big picture. His attic would be well organized, modern, and up to today's standards so it can work for him and his family when needed.